Climate denier, denier of science. Yes, this is what you're called if you have any questions about the ongoing weather holocaust that's surely engulfing the planet as we speak. And if predictions are correct, we'll drown everyone in the world except the few who believe in the climate prediction models. My name is Liam Sheff. My book is Official Stories. This is American Heretic. What is it to be a denier in the sciences when you're talking about weather? How can you be a denier of climate? You go outside, you're experiencing weather. Weather is part of the larger climate. What is it to be a denier then? Well, it is to not believe in the modeling of the IPCC, the NOAA, and other intergovernmental agencies, which have been telling us for a long time that we're all in for it based on carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. It may or may not affect the weather at all, maybe a tiny bit. Nobody can really say, but the mainstream says that it is the chief driver of weather on Earth. Now, if you're going to come out and tell people something as dramatic as we know what the chief principal driver of weather on Earth is, I think that you have it all figured out. Therefore, all of your models, what's that? All of your 70 models, or none of them? None of them. None of the models of the IPCC, the NOAA, have been accurate. Wow, they've made terrible gaps in predictions. They've had terrible, terrible failings, so that people from inside of these groups have defected and said our modeling is absolute shit. If their modeling isn't any good, and it isn't, they didn't predict the slowdown in global warming, the giant pause. They now say that it's back on, but that depends on whose numbers you trust. They have changed their data. They have scandalously fudged numbers and changed numbers that were reported earlier by saying we didn't know what they were, but now we do, and now we have to change them so they confirm our bias. This isn't science anymore. This is something tantamount to religion. The weather is going to change. Global warming is coming. Global warming is coming. The seas are going to rise. When are they going to rise? 2010. New York's not underwater. 2015. New York's not underwater. 2025. It's like dealing with fundamentalist Christians who keep telling me that Jesus is coming back, and so I have to believe. I absolutely have to believe. If I'm bad, my stockings will be filled with coal. Maybe I'm mixing something up there, but Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. When? Didn't the Jews in ancient Rome say that Jesus was coming and that was just supposed to be back then? Yes, but he's coming. He's coming. Don't argue. He's coming. Be good. Do what we say. Be good. Be afraid of the stuff we say to be afraid of. When is he coming? He's coming. When is the weather going to change? When is the sea going to rise? You better have a good model and a good track record of modeling this stuff. But if you go back to the 1800s, early 1900s in the newspapers, every couple of years there was going to be a new ice age. No, the new ice age is coming. But it didn't happen. What? Oh, it must be a heat spell. We're going to have the whole planet's going to become a desert. And what's that? It didn't happen. The oceans are going to rise. It's going to be Noah's flood all over again. It has a very religious feeling to it. Everybody's always promising the rapture in the sciences these days. HIV is going to take over the world by 1990. What's that? Didn't happen? Oh my God, global warming is going to kill us all. Gee, measles is going to spread and swamp the United States with children with little spots. Oh my God, what's that? It didn't happen. In fact, in 100% vaccinated groups, those are the people who got sick. Well, trust us. Trust us. Let us genetically modify anything we want and put it into whomever we want because we're in charge. The rapture is coming. The rapture is coming. Climate denialism. If you don't believe their modeling and you have some questions, then you're a denier of, they say, science. But they don't own science, and they certainly don't own the Earth, and they don't own the weather. Let's ask the most important question that they never ask. What is the most important question? If you're going to talk about predictions about weather, it is, why is there weather at all? Why are there vertical spinning winds that go 300 miles per hour? Why? Why? It's a rock in space with water on it. Why are there vertical spinning winds that go 300 miles per hour? Why are there trillions of tons of water held over our heads at all times? Seemingly not obeying the law of gravity very well, unless gravity is electromagnetic. Well, don't say that. We'll get to it. Why does this happen? Why do we live in a world that violates so many laws of, well, what we think we know about weather? What drives weather? Ask the mainstream and they'll tell you. It's a little warm air and a little cold air. The warm air meets the cold air and therefore decides to go like this. No, really. It goes like this and then it goes like this and then it goes 300 miles per hour. See? And then lightning happens. What? Wait. But why does it always circular? Why does it always spiral? What do you mean lightning happens? That's a good question. Maybe this is too big. Maybe we could trust the NOAA and the IPCC and NASA and the rest of the government agencies and the meteorological agencies if they could just answer this one question. Lightning. 8 million lightning strikes per day. 8 million, estimated. Megawatts of electricity funneling down from the clouds. K-k-k-k-k-k. And up from the Earth. K-k-k-k-k. And then from the clouds to the ionosphere. And then from the ionosphere down to the clouds. We have lightning going up and down, from the planet to the ionosphere, the planet to the ionosphere. Now, why would that happen? Why? The mainstream says a little warm water, no, a little not frozen water, meets a little more frozen water in the cloud. 8 million megawatts of 8 million strokes of Go to your freezer, carefully, open it up and sit. You might get struck by lightning. If you're running a 7-Eleven, step away from the Slurpee machine. You're generating electricity, but you don't know it. Maybe it just doesn't happen here, just up there where we can't see it. No. The mainstream says it's because a little cold water meets a little more cold water and makes lightning. They know it's not true. And they even leave themselves an out. We're still doing research. Let me help you. This is the Earth. The Earth goes through space. Space is, I know it's a lemon, it's a metaphor. Earth goes through space. Space is not neutral. Space is electrically charged. Space is a plasma. All of outer space is plasma. It is electrically charged. Earth is in a magnetosphere. No, it's not to scale. Earth is in a little electromagnetic bubble that deflects all of the energy around it. There's an ionosphere around this. Ions are electrical. The ionosphere is charged positively. The Earth is charged negatively. There is an interplay between the top of the ionosphere where it's charged positively and the Earth where it's charged negatively. What could possibly happen? This is the Sun. No, it's not to scale. And I think it's GMO. God. This is the genetically modified Sun. This is the Earth. It's not to scale. The Sun is constantly emitting, pouring out electromagnetic energy, boom, 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 coronal mass ejections, the solar current, not really a solar wind, ions, electrons, neutrinos, a constant bombardment of electromagnetic particles at different energy levels. They bombard the planets. Our planet is bombarded by electromagnetic energy. That energy hits the ionosphere. The ionosphere then rains down onto the planet. The negative planet charges to the clouds. The clouds are in the middle of the electrical layer, and we're constantly discharging between two electrical layers. We're constantly discharging between two electrical layers. Wait a second. You're saying that lightning, which is electrical, is a constant discharge between two electrical layers? No! That doesn't make any sense. What happened to the snow cone machine in the sky? Right. It does make a little sense, though, you have to admit. Now, I didn't invent it. I want to give credit where credit is due, and I will at the end of the video. But let's just say this. The mainstream cannot tell you why there's lightning. Lightning is the most predictable weather event on the planet. It happens 8 million times a day. And the mainstream has no idea why. Because if they invoked the electricity of outer space and the sun, they would have to retire Neil deGrasse Tyson. They would have to retire Carl Sagan. They would have to retire the Big Bang model. You don't need, first there was nothing which exploded in an electrically powered universe. You'd have to retire Charles Darwin too, because life on Earth wouldn't occur by blind accidental chance in a random mutating number game. It would be electrically motivated, and we would see it as such, and we could make predictions to some degree that life existed everywhere in the universe and unraveled in the cocoon of electromagnetically charged, wet, rocky planets. Now, I want to thank Walt Thornhill, Don Scott, other great researchers who have forwarded the electrical universe model. You can go to thunderbolts.info. They're having a conference in June. My name is Liam Sheff. I wrote about this in Chapter 9 of my book, Official Stories. This is American Heretic. Please support independent science journalism. The universe is electric.